One of the things we were asked to do in the book is to present it in a way that students can open up the book and feel comfortable right away. Teaching religion courses is very difficult because most students come in with a religion. So if you talk about a very different religion, they're not going to recognize it as a religion.
This text is, to my knowledge, the first that incorporates the really cutting-edge discussions going on in the academy and whether or not the category religion is suitable for any tradition other than modern Christianity.
We started each chapter with a New Yorker cartoon, and we also use quotations. For example, in the very first chapter, we use a quotation from Desmond Tutu. He says, when the missionaries came to Africa, they had the Bible and we had the land. They said, let us pray, and we closed our eyes. When we opened our eyes, we had the Bible and they had the land.
Well, there is an enormous distinction between studying religion as a devotee or a participant in that tradition and the academic study of religion. And that's a distinction that has to be made at the beginning of every text and the beginning of every course. When you're studying your own religion, you're being taught usually what's good or bad, right or wrong. And you don't study other traditions. In the academic study of religion, you simply describe as accurately as possible what people believe to be true or false, right or wrong, good or bad, in various contexts, and why they change over time, because all traditions change over time.
A good example that we have in the book is a box called Is Slavery Wrong? And we have a very graphic picture of a slave whose back has just been whipped and whipped and whipped. He looks like he couldn't even still be alive. And it points out that before 1770, no major religious tradition condemned slavery. The World Christian Encyclopedia counts 10,000 religions in the world, and under each of those, there's subdivisions. So under Christianity, they count 9,000 denominations and 34,000 sects. So some of our colleagues don't even use the word Christianity in the singular. Instead, they talk about Christianities and Judaisms and Hinduism.
We do address the question, is it possible to have a religion of one person? In general, most people would say no. It's not just a discussion group. A discussion group wouldn't be. A book club isn't a religion. Sometimes people think of introductory courses as the easiest to teach, and so they put beginning teachers in those courses. I think we've both found out from experience that they're the hardest ones to teach.
If you go to bartender school, they tell you two things don't talk about with your clients. One is politics, and the other is religion. Because most people have their politics or their religion in a very deep part of their consciousness, but they haven't thought it out with arguments and with proofs.
Ultimately, the goal is to contribute to liberal arts education. The purpose of a liberal arts education is to train citizens in understanding other people's religious traditions, other people's values, other people's orientations towards life is essential to the training of a citizen.
Well, the end of chapter one is a photograph taken of Pope John Paul II. But in this one, he's got his fingers like this and he's looking out. And that one just takes a figure that you've seen in dignified positions and it just shows him clowning around, loosening up. And that's kind of an emblem of what we want the students to be able to do. Not to drop their faith commitment, not to look at their own tradition and say it's not equivalent to the others or better than the others, but just to be able to compare and contrast. And that's what scholarship is in any field, the ability to say this is like the other things and this is unlike other things and this is where it came from and this is how it got there.